Hey guys, Ernie here, and welcome to the Paleo Hiker MD channel. Last year, I tried out a couple of products from the company Goshawk. This is a company out of Australia, and they're doing a lot of really interesting things with stoves. And after I did a review on one of their stoves called the Steampunk, they reached out to me probably, it's probably been 8 or 9 months ago, and they said, hey, listen, we've got some new products coming out. We'd love for you to check it out. You don't have to do a review. You don't have to do anything at all. We just want to send it to you. We know that you love this outdoor gear, and if you do like it and you want to make a video, that's great. If not, don't worry about it. Well, who am I to refuse a couple of free stoves? So stay tuned. We're going to take a look at one of the stoves they sent me today, the Victoria. It's kind of a take on the traditional Trangia. Stay tuned. I think you guys are going to like it. So before we talk about this stove in particular, let's talk about the Trangia, because this is based on the basic footprint of the Trangia. So why do people like that stove so much? It is solidly built. It's stood the test of time. It's got a screw-on cap so you can keep alcohol inside of it. It's also got a simmer ring so you don't have to just have it full bore all the time. You can cut down the flame and just simmer something very steadily. It's also a very reasonable price, but I think the biggest reason that people love the Trangia so much is that so many products are made to fit with it. The basic footprint, the dimensions, you can put it inside of all kinds of different stands, cook systems that are designed specifically to hold this classic stove. Or spirit burner, not a stove. You know what I mean. So we'll take a quick look at the Victoria. On first glance, it looks like another classic Trangia clone. We've looked at a bunch of different clones here, said, are they any better? Are they any different? Well, let me tell you guys, this is no simple Trangia clone. So this is the Victoria from Goshawk. You've got two parts. You've got the actual stove itself, okay, the burner, and the pot stand right here. Dimensions are 4.1 by 3.1 by 2. We will weigh the individual components for you guys here so you can see it. Just got a new scale here. So the stove itself, you may not be able to see it. The stove itself with the top and the simmer ring is 4.4 ounces. The stand itself is 1.6. Put them together, you've got 5.9 ounces. It's made out of brass. As I said, it has a screw-on cap and the simmer ring. If you open this up, you'll see. The price, by the way, is $29.95. Now, it claims to boil 2 cups of water in 5 minutes. That's a pretty strong statement. When you store it, you put it on top here, and it just pops in, and it stores pretty low compact like that. When you use it, you put it like this, and then you pop this on top just like that. Now, we turn the lights down. I'm going to show you guys the flame pattern on this bad boy because it's really pretty cool. We'll add just a little bit of alcohol here, just enough to get it going. So, light that up. You can see where this is pretty much kind of like a windproof stand, okay? This is a capillary stove, so it looks like a Trangia, but instead of the flame just coming straight up, you'll see here in a second, I'm going to move this a little bit forward for you guys, you'll see here in a second that it has this capillary action, and it is really cool. The jets are angled so that it kind of creates a vortex effect, and it should pop up there. It's starting to go. Now it's starting to go pretty well. You guys can see that kind of vortex appearance. It'll keep getting a little bit stronger. That's about as far as I can zoom in, but I'll zoom you in a little bit with just the camera. The air conditioner is on and the fan is on above me, and you can see it kind of playing a little bit of havoc with it. Let's give it a little bit of protection. You can see there, it's really going nice. Really nice flame pattern. Really cool stove, guys. Really, really cool stove. That is the Goshawk Victoria. Now let's get this thing. We're going to boil 2 cups of water with it. We'll boil 2 cups of water with a Trangia. Like I said, I do not have a Trangia with me, so I'll insert 2 cups of water being boiled with a Trangia, and then we'll boil 2 cups of water with this bad boy. By the way, we'll also see how long it burns with 1 ounce of fuel. So let's go straight to the pros and the cons. Pros, I think, first of all, the cost is very reasonable. You're getting not just the stove itself, but also a pot stand and essentially a wind stand altogether, or a windscreen altogether. So for this one single cost, you get the stove, you get the pot stand, and you get the windscreen. It not only comes with a simmer ring, but the simmer ring actually works in any position while it is in the pot stand, which doesn't work with all these things. You'll get a pot stand and then you realize, oh, that's great, but you can't use a simmer ring. That's not the case with this one. It also is, of course, the same dimensions as a Trangia. It'll fit inside of a 750 milliliter pot very simply, and it'll fit inside of any product that's designed to use with the Trangia. It also has a faster boil time. So how about that? Cons, I mean, I'll tell you guys honestly, I don't know that I have any. Maybe it's new, so we don't know if it's gonna last forever. Maybe that's it. Maybe weight. That's about it. Boil time claims from companies always need to be taken with a grain of salt, but this was actually a very good estimation of what the boil time turned out to be. I was a little bit surprised. I didn't think it would boil as fast as it did. So here's to you, Gosok. What's more important is comparative testing, and that's what we saw today. We compared the Trangia with this new kind of Trangia clone, or a spin on a Trangia clone, and you can see that the changes that Gosok made to the design using this kind of capillary hoop stove system, it just works, and it works better than the traditional Trangia. So is it better than the traditional Trangia? Well, I will say it is different. I'm not going to say it's better, at least not yet. This is a new stove with a new design. It is not time tested. We have all used Trangias for years. My oldest Trangia is probably over 10 years old. It still works just fine. It's got a little patina to it, but other than that, it looks brand new and it works perfectly. I don't know if this stove will work long term. Will it fail? Will it have a problem? I mean, it doesn't look like it will, but it might. So I think before we automatically say, hey, this is better than the Trangia, I think we need to give it some time. So far, so good. I see no reason to think that it wouldn't be better or a different viable option to the Trangia. But if I have any problems with it, I will let y'all know. As always, I keep testing these things over and over. I like to go out, use these things. I use alcohol stoves a lot inside just to make coffee in the morning, just for fun. So I'll use this stove quite a bit. If I ever run into problems, I will make a specific video about the product that fails and why it failed. So what do you guys think? What do you think about this particular stove? Do you like it? Do you not like it? Do you think it's worth the money? Do you think it's a piece of crap? Throw it down in the comments. Let's hear it. I'm sure you guys will have an opinion. There is never a lack of opinion on YouTube. Do me a big favor, guys. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up down below. It really helps spread things across YouTube. That is my goal. If you are not subscribed, and I know, look, the analytics don't lie. A lot of you guys are not subscribed to this channel. If you like the video, why not hit that subscription button? Make sure you don't miss any videos. If you want to be absolutely sure you don't miss any videos, hit that notification bell and you will be the first to know. Back home, enjoying a little time at home. Had to go back and reshoot some of this video because the audio was total garbage on my original video. I have all the testing footage from my trip to Arkansas, but the narration and the discussion about the stove was garbage. Anyway, as always, guys, I appreciate you checking out the Paleo Hiker MD channel. Stay tuned for more videos soon.